ready to go, man. He knows what he's doing. He's badass, you know.
Now, Ruben, you're an expert in southpaws. Your son's a southpaw.
Oh, yeah.
Are you a softball?
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
And we're fighting a softball. So, hey.
Just like Manny Pacquiao and Earl Spence, two softballs going at it. What can we expect from your fight and from Manny Pacquiao Spence fight? Two softballs.
I expect Errol Spence to put up a great fight for like six rounds, but Pacquiao is probably going to catch him later in the fight.
You got Pacquiao winning?
I got Pacquiao. Wow. Pacquiao's a legend. He's too much experience.
Ruben, what do you think?
I got Pacquiao. You see what he did to Thurman? He was talking a lot of bullshit, man. I'm the big man. I'm the big guy. But Pacquiao's been there for a long time. He's fast, powerful, and he fought a lot of... He's one of the best lefties in the world. He never fought a lefty like him. You know what I mean? So, hey, that makes a lot of difference.
What is it for a lefty to fight a lefty? Because usually lefties have the advantage because nobody's used to fighting or sparring a lefty. But when there's two, they're in the mirror, they both might be out of, like, not used to it.
Hey, the ones that don't make no mistakes, you know? And I think Pacquiao knows his game. So he's got a game plan for him, you know?
In the history of boxing, where do you guys place Manny Pacquiao out of everybody that ever fought in the sport?
History of what?
In boxing. Is Manny Pacquiao number one, number two, number three, number four?
Well, right now, to me, he's not. He's like a number one because he's still winning, man. He's 40-something years old, man, and he's 40, still in the game.
42.
He's still in the game, man. So I got to give him that prop. He earned it, you know what I mean?
Where do you have him? Pacquiao,
in the history of boxing, I got him like, I'd put him at number three.
Who's one and two?
Number one. That one's debatable, but number two, I got Chavez. Julio Cesar Chavez. Number three, Pacquiao.
Okay, Ruben Guerrero. How about your son, Robert Guerrero, Manny Pacquiao? Fight never happened. What happens if they fight?
Hey, we're waiting for the winner. We're going to get, I hope we get the shot. I'm pretty sure we're going to get it. So we got to shine first, man. We're going to get in the ring.
Robert's
I got Robert
back.
Guerrero yep. coming up, getting ready, and we got some big things coming up, man.
Tell people where to follow you on Instagram.
Fierro _408. It's FIERRRO. _408.
And where do they follow Ruben at?
Mad Dog Guerrero Boxing.
Make sure to follow and stay tuned. Check out the gym, pound for pound in Gilroy.
You got it.
Every day it's open. You can come. Do you love the gym?
I love the gym. I'm there every day.
There you have it, man. I didn't even recognize you today. You look so different from last week. That's amazing. Good job. Hey, you stay ready so you don't have to get ready. And you took the fight at a 3-week notice.
Hey, he looks like me right now, man. Looks like me.
Yeah. Twins! There you have it. FiestaJapoin.com. We take back reporting. Hey, did your son ever fight Broner?
No. Hey,
how about a fight with Robert and Broner?
Oh, dude, Broner won't go there, bro. We called him out one time, hey, and we talked a lot of bullshit. He wanted to fight Robert, and then he signed the contract, bro. Yeah, so, hey.
Maybe now's the time.
Maybe, hey. We're hoping, bro. You know, ready to go. Yeah.
Your son and Conor McGregor?
Oh, anytime. We'll take that fight.
How
man.
Easy of a fight is that?
That'll be an easy fight for Robert, man. Robert knocks his head off, man. Take care of him. He'll knock him out.
There you have it. You heard it here first.
That'll be a big fight, though, man, with Robert Guerrero.
By the way, Mad Dog, last time I did the video about your car, the whole world went crazy. They love your car. I got to come back and do another one.
Oh, that's just one of them. You ought to see the other one, man.
You got a whole fleet?
I got a fleet line. And then I got a 64 convertible, Super Sport. And I got another 58 convertible. And then I got a 38 Chevy, shop top, suicide doors. Oh, dude,
you know
haven't
what
seen
else?
Nothing.
Your son told me, Robert told me, do you have French bulldog? And then you put weights on them so they get stronger.
Oh, yeah.
Your dogs don't need to put weights. They're not fighters.
Hey, they got to be ready, man. Shit. You
know, they're shadow boxing? What are they? Running?
I run them in the treadmill a little bit.
They do?
I work them out. They gotta work out. I like them in shape.
Why do you love French bulldogs? Why not with Rottweilers? Why not German shepherds?
I just like them because they're
small. Personality?
And they're lovable. They love people, man. They're good dogs, man. That's in right now.
Yeah. I'm going to get one day. Tyler, what do you think? French bulldogs?
Man, a lot of money in French bulldogs.
A lot of money in that.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I'm going to have a breed coming up pretty soon. So
hit up check, Mad Dog.
Hit up Mad Dog.
Mad Dog, what do they go for? People want to buy one.
Oh, well, my dog, they go for at least 5, 6, 7,000.
Okay, good.
It depends on breed, how big they are, how little, you know, it depends.
All right, there you have it, guys. You want a French bulldog? Mad Dog Guerrero.
Right here, Mad Dog Guerrero.
Reporting.